Guys, this might be my own personal torture. Hottest day of the year, and I'm by a pool, and I'm wearing a suit. There's just something not fair about all of this, but I guess I really can't complain because, frankly, there are a lot of people out here that are working a lot harder than I am. This is the way to spend a summer day as the temperatures hover around triple digits, but not everybody has the option of playing in the pool. A lot of people, like farmers, have to be outside. It's how they pay the bills. But Keith Fry has the right idea. His tractor has air conditioning.
I had, heart attack and bypass surgery 9 years ago. I couldn't possibly stay out here in this heat all day.
But if air-conditioned tractors aren't an option, well, you have to come up with other ways to keep cool.
Gallons and gallons of water. Stay hydrated.
I bring a spray bottle of water with me, and I spray it on myself throughout the day when it gets really hot.
Every hour we take about a 15-minute break, or if once you start getting overheated, feeling overheated, go drink some water, sit down, sit in the shade.
And then there's Ron Watt. He works outside with heavy machinery, but he also works for a company that practices safety first.
We have a safety meeting every morning, and we basically go over the signs of heat exhaustion, heat stroke.
Watt also says he's been trained to look for signs of heat stroke and how to perform CPR, education that's needed if you're not the guy with the air-conditioned tractor.
A big, big advantage. I wouldn't be out here if it wasn't air-conditioned. I'm going to get back in a minute.
And that's a good idea. Stay in the air conditioning as much as you can. Some signs of heat stroke to look for. Clammy skin, you might feel dizzy, and you might feel disoriented. We're live at Schenley Pool. Ari Hait, Channel 4 Action News.